Florida State, the home team, as you check out the starting lineups for OU, brought to you by Capital One. And we feature Alyssa Brito. Yesterday in the game one win, she went 3 for 3 and hit the 2 home runs. And for the second night in a row, they will face freshman Ashton Danley. She took the loss yesterday through 2 innings, 6 hits, 3 earned runs out of Winchester, Tennessee. A top 5 recruit coming out of high school, and she has not disappointed for the Seminoles, 18-6 on the season, as they have relied heavily on their underclass arms. First pitch swing for Coleman out in front. So the second day in a row that these Sooner hitters will see Danley.
And the key for Danley this evening is going to be that changeup. Yesterday it was elevated at times. She was having a hard time throwing it for a strike.
That one rolls up to the plate. That was 1-1.
Well, not being predictable with it because Sooners were sitting changeup by the time they got second time through the order. In fact, they talk about it post the game, how much they love changeups.
Coleman, the senior out of the Colony in Texas, was 0-for-3, but did draw a walk and ended up scoring the game-winning run in the bottom of the 5th as the Sooners walked it off with a run roll, just the 3rd time all year that the Noles suffered an early exit. Here's the 1-2 from Danley. Missed it inside. It is another hot, sunny, steamy night here in Norman for the pitchers to deal with, the perspiration and the humidity. Full count for an Oklahoma lineup that walks more than any team in the country. Both these clubs very good at drawing the free passes. Lays off and the leadoff walk for Coleman.
Ashton Danley, this freshman sensation. She's going to be in the mid-60s. She's got that really good lefty spin. She works all edges of the zone with that curveball on both sides. It's that effective off-speed that even if she's not throwing that for strike, she needs to be able to use it, needs to be competitive so she can effectively use it with that velocity differential.
All right, another one that rolls in to T.R.A. Jennings is having herself a tournament. 6-for-14, that's a .429 batting average in the postseason with 3 home runs, including one last night.
And her swing of every, more than any other Sooner hitter in this lineup, matches up very well against down. She hits more fly balls than anyone in the country. Really has that swing path that gets underneath the ball, does well with anything waist below.
In for a strike, 2-1. Crazy Jennings stat in her 4-year career. Half her hits are for extra bases. All-time doubles leader. She's tied for 2nd all-time in home runs. And Danley falls behind for the 2nd hitter in a row. Tom Meyer behind the plate, Steve Gould, Dustin Douglas, Chelsea Clark on the bases this evening. Opposite way for Jennings on the move, coming in to make the catch is Harding, 1 down. Kaylee gets the start out in right field today. Moves Janai Kerr over into center. And Mudge, your usual spot over and left. Parker. The lineup card does have McKenna Reed in that flex spot, so they have a lot of versatility in the lineup to move a lot of pieces around. Mazella Parker steps in. One for three, walked, scored a run in game one.
Wow, back-to-back changeup's outstanding. That's the pitch. And when she's really slowing that down, that's when it's going to be most effective.
It's spinning. You see the spin on that thing?
Tight.
It comes out of the hand, and it's hard to pick up.
Danley ahead 0-2. Just missed it low. Earlier this week, it was announced Ella, as well as Jasoni Beauchamp, the starting third baseman for Florida State tonight. There you go. Two of the top three rookies in the country with Keegan Rothrock. Florida's ace picked up a win today against Baylor in game one in Gainesville. Parker chops that one over Beauchamp's head and back onto the grass. And a couple of aboard for the number four hitter, Alyssa Brito, who had the two long balls yesterday.
She's protecting changeup. Watch how late she is to make sure she doesn't get beat on the change. And just strength, pure strength. This is a slapper, right? You're talking like slap the ball, use the dirt. But a nice job with two strikes to protect it, get yourself a knock.
Senior out of Tustin, California. Started her career at Oregon and found a new home a few years ago here with the Sooners. Four for 12 so far in this NCAA tournament after they swept through the regionals. Yesterday, the third multi-home run game of the season for Brito. Early RBI opportunity here for OU. Danley misses away, 3-0.
Brito had the green light yesterday, 3-0, hit it out of the park.
And the bases are loaded. Couple of walks here in the first. So yesterday, Florida State did this in the first inning, loaded the bases, but then could not get a run in. And now a chance for Oklahoma here tonight in the first. Cassidy Pickering, freshman from Humble, Texas. Infield in for the Seminoles.
Situation with the lefty up, probably can't turn the double play up the middle, so they decide to pull in to go home.
Cassidy was 2 for 2 in her Supers debut. Does have a grand slam this year. It's an Oklahoma offense. Third best in the country this year, hitting home runs behind Miami of Ohio and Virginia Tech. Her up. Torres drifting back, able to make the catch. Nobody advances. Two down.
That's a quality pitch in a big situation.
Danley trying to work out of the jam. It's Kinsey Hansen, the senior catcher, who has reached in 27 consecutive games. Had a two-run home run last night. In for a strike.
Yeah.
0-2.
Nice curveball in the inner half. Ashton Danley is a freshman, has been very good at being able to throw across her body inside to righties. Big part of her game.
Waits on it, slow roller to third, and Beecham will step on the base. OU leaves them loaded. Florida State picking up the bats when we come back. Let's take a look at the Florida State starting lineup brought to you by Capital One. And we highlight these Florida State seniors trying to stave off playing in their last game in a Seminole jersey and get another game tomorrow. They have combined for 110 runs batted in this season. And the Noles will look to them to lead here tonight. They've worked out of a bases loaded jam, and now they get a chance to pick up the bats. And they will face Kirsten Deal. In the month of May, just 3 appearances and only 6 innings of work. As she makes her second start in a month here tonight in game 2.
Deal's given up 7 home runs on the year, but one of the keys for her, she's done a good job at limiting the base on balls, only 17 on the year. It's gonna be one of the keys against this Florida State team. You mentioned it earlier, Beth, this Florida State team walks a lot, just like Oklahoma.
She did pick up a win in the Big 12 tournament against BYU, but a bit of a surprise here that the Sooners did not come back with Nicole May to get the start today.
Nicole will be ready to come in. I think the biggest decision is that Kirsten Deal, younger pitcher, more comfortable starting than coming in relief. That's actually the most runs that she's given up is in her relief appearances.
Carly Keeney is already out there as well as Jason E. Beecham steps in. Just a terrific story. Grew up a Florida State fan living in Tallahassee. Her dad, Demetrius, a big influence in her softball career. Came into her life as a youngster, and she gives him a lot of credit for taking her around the country, teaching her a lot about the game, and all she's done is reward him and Seminole fans with one of the best freshman seasons they've ever seen at the plate.
She's one of those that Lonnie Almeida's known her since she was 5, 6 years old, coming to camps. Her dream always to play in Florida State.
Either side real happy with what looks like a tight strike zone to start. Beecham into the side netting.
And that's what Beecham does a really good job of. She inside outs the softball, so anytime, especially lefties, the best hitters against lefties in the country, they try to come inside with that curveball, and she can keep her hands inside it better than anybody.
Full count to Beecham. Sanders charges and applies the tag, one down. How about the scout for Kirsten Deal?
No, she's gonna throw in the upper 60s. She's got some down in the zone, really good spin, but she can move the ball around. She's got curve on both sides. She will slip in a rise ball from time to time. Not a lot of mix of speeds, but has that very good lefty spin and movement.
Here's Kaylee Harding, and the first of the seniors to step to the plate. Out of Murfreesboro, Tennessee. 1-for-2, scored a run last night. Getting way back in the box, that right foot on the chalk. See Harding. One of those players that has the ability to change a game with one swing.
back. Lonnie Alameda changed her lineup to put the big three. 1, 2, 3. Mm-hmm. Move Kaylee Mudge down in the lineup.
Mudge down to sixth with Edenfield there on deck. 1-2. Hard ground ball to Tiara Jennings. 2 down.
And we welcome you to Love's Field here in Norman, Oklahoma. Those of you that just watched Texas A&M shock the top seed Texas Longhorns in game one of the Austin Super Regional. So the number one seed in big trouble. They're going to have to come back and win two straight or the Aggies will advance. Game two of that series tomorrow here in Norman. Oklahoma, a winner last night, 11-3, a run rule victory. They hit 4 home runs to beat Florida State. So the Noles in a must-win situation here tonight to force a game three tomorrow. Beth Bowens alongside our Olympic gold medalists, Jessica Mendoza and Michelle Smith. Ah, the mayhem, ladies, already.
Already.
Higher seeded teams losing today because the 10 seed Duke also upset the 7 seed Missouri on the road this afternoon. Winner of this Super Regional will face the winner of that Columbia Super Regional at the World Series opening day. Kirsten Deal gets the start. And now a 1-2 count with 2 down to Michaela Edenfield, the number 3 batter in the lineup. Seminoles, even though they're on the road, they are the home team here in game 2. Skies the 1-2. Torres calls off Sanders in a 1-2-3 start. Back to the Norman Super Regional, Florida State. And Oklahoma down there at the bottom. Winners today, Tennessee and Duke. Winners last night, Oklahoma and UCLA. So a must-win situation tonight for Florida State. Hi, everybody. Beth Mullins, Jessica Mendoza, Michelle Smith. What's it going to take tonight, Jess, for the Seminoles to turn things around and force another game?
Kind of Florida State's, pitching staff, what we've seen is all hands on deck. We're already seeing it right now. Danley went inning 1. We got McKenna Reed, new pitcher, inning 2. Mimi Gooden's going to come into this game, and they have to be perfect on defense, attack offensively.
Yeah, and for Oklahoma, they're just going to need to put runs up on the board like they have all year long. They're needing to capitalize on the free passes when they get them, and, of course, use the long ball. That's been a big part of their game, to be able to score with those long balls.
And for the Seminoles, well, they've been in this situation before, 2014, 2018. They lost game 1 of the Supers, came back to win games 2 and 3. And of course, that 2018 team went on to win the national championship. Top 2, Sooners coming back up. They left the bases loaded in the first. That was against Ashton Danley. Now McKenna Reed on to face the bottom of the lineup. And the way they set up their lineup today, Danley could re-enter. We anticipate a lot of changes to stay versatile and to give themselves the best chance to win. For Lonnie Alameda, winner of that 2018 national championship back home where she played collegiately in the old Big 8 Conference. 2-time All-Leaguer here at Oklahoma.
Reminder, too, that McKenna Reed is throwing in her first game in a month. She's been battling injury, and huge appearance for her right here. Entire season on the line.
3-0 to Boone. It's in for a strike. Her last appearance was April 21st, went an inning and 2/3. And also in that Boston College series was her last start, where she went 2 2/3. Boone pulls that to Devin Flaherty. 1 down. Last night we saw Maddie Balk in the circle for 1 inning. Her 4th appearance of the season. So the issue has been injuries to some of their players, including Reed. And it's been a season where they have had to rely heavily on their underclass arms
Earlier this week, it was Allison Royalty who announced that she would be retiring. Yanked down the line and foul.
It's been a tough year for Florida State and their bullpen. They've had a lot of injuries. They've had to pitch by committee.
What was Lonnie's? It's not Johnny Allstaff today. Who is
Jeanette.
It? Jeanette Allstaff.
She's like, we'll take Johnny too.
Yeah, exactly.
We'll take all we can get.
21 outs. Whoever will give us this 21 outs, we're going to use them.
Just a fabulous pitching guru. Has had all ACC and all American pitchers as long as you can remember. Megan King, who was the stud of their championship team, had one of the best World Series ERAs ever. Here's Alina Torres. Waits on it. Backhanded. Torres over to first. Got her deep in the hole. Two down.
Well, Torres, the freshman, has just been outstanding coming in for the Noles, playing that shortstop position where there's been so much history of so many great players. She's going to go into that 5-6 hole. Look at the way she really just drives that backside down into the ground. So she's got a nice gun across. Good job by Ross over at first for the stretch, but really nice pickup by Torres.
Not easy to replace Josie Muffley, who'd been there seemingly forever. Their great shortstop.
Well, and shortstops are leaders, and that's probably been the biggest thing for Issa Torres is the talent's there. That's why she's playing the position, but how much she's grown into being vocal, being a leader, understanding the infield.
Sanders fouls one off. Boy, and you go back to Beecham, too, at third base. How happy is Lonnie to see these two together for three more years after this? And when you look at defensive runs saved amongst the players in the Supers, they are two of the best at their positions. Oh, 2. This would be big just for McKenna's mindset to get the 1-2-3 here. Was fabulous last year, one of just three pitchers in the country that was undefeated.
As a freshman last year, she came in and was mostly used in relief. Her very first start ever was against Clemson.
And we caught
that
game.
We were there. And all of a sudden, here's this freshman lefty shows up, popping the ball at 70 miles an hour, wins her first game when Clemson was a highly ranked team.
A terrific combo with Kat Sandercock.
She's lost some of that velocity. You mentioned hitting 70 miles an hour pretty consistently last year. She sits more like 65, 66, but has relied more on that off speed. She just threw it there to Sanders.
Sanders pops it up, and it is indeed a 1-2-3 inning for McKenna Reed, working the bottom of the order. Thanks, Matt. What a stunner in the opening game of that best of three. Still to come later tonight, 10 Eastern on ESPNU, the 8-9 matchup, their game one, Stanford and LSU. But how about the Aggies? Wow, putting the number one seed in jeopardy.
Impressive, Emily Kennedy, shutting down a strong Texas offense.
4, 5, and 6 here for the Noles against Kirsten Deal. So we've been doing this seeding thing and Super Regionals for 19 years now, 2005. Only twice has the number one seed failed to reach the World Series. So a little bit of history perhaps in the making. Any guesses?
Who the?
One team was courtesy of Hawaii Home Runs.
Oh, Alabama.
And the other one was courtesy of a one of the greatest dog piles in the history of the game.
Florida. Lou Harris Champer in Georgia with the walk-off.
Kailipuailoa. Kailipuailoa.
Last name or first name. Working on it. Going back. Reel it in. Come on.
Only happened twice.
Yeah.
Of course, Alabama put a big scare into Tennessee today, and Florida winner in their first game against Baylor is Torres. Pulls that one out to right. Pickering drifts under. One down. Back to one of the seniors now, actually back to back with Devin Flaherty, then Kaylee Mudge. .207 wins together. 23 of those in the NCAA tournament. They are one of the most decorated groups in Florida State and ACC history. Two trips to the championship series in Oklahoma City, a couple of ACC regular season titles, a couple of ACC tournament titles. And Lonnie Alameda likes to say 2B is our QB. Flaherty right here at the plate.
Had a single yesterday, hottest hitter coming out of regionals. It was a hit machine. Left side, right side, short game.
Flaherty launches one deep center. Coleman reaching for the wall, has room, and the catch on the track. Flaherty put that one in flight. Two down.
I like so far, both those balls hit hard off of Deal. Torres, Flaherty, both 2-0 counts, and Florida State being aggressive, not watching, attacking those pitches, knowing they're leveraged. It's a good mindset for Lonnie Alameda's offense.
Here's Mudge, the senior from Winter Springs, Florida. Lonnie says she brings the spark, the light and the joy to this lineup. It's hard to believe we hardly knew her for the first, 50 games of her freshman year, and then this just explosion in the postseason and at the World Series.
Set a record.
14 hits at the time until T.R.A. Jennings broke it.
Yep. I love it when I can just say, set a record, and then you know it exactly.
Here's a tee. Beth, go ahead and knock it out.
She had a five-hit game in that World Series when they made it to the finals. Deal gets the swing and miss.
Left-on-left curveball. Tougher pitches for any left-handed batter to stay with.
Full count. Florida State looking for its first base runner of the night. And there it is.
The center fielder, number 4, Janai Kerr.
Here comes Janai Kerr out of Mableton, Georgia. 1-for-3 with an RBI single in game one last night. Here's a look at Lonnie. 10th super regional appearance. She's 5-4 in those.
She's
went into the Hall of Fame in December.
Kerr off the glove of Sanders, and it ricocheted off of Mudge. And Janai safe at first. That's an E3, and now a scoring opportunity for Amaya Ross.
Rare error for Sydney Sanders. You can see she had already shifted her weight to go back to first. Pops off her glove, then pops off the foot of Mudge because it had already hit the glove. All is fair.
Ross, the only Knoll to start every game this year. Junior, a reserve her first two seasons and worked her way into the lineup. 0 for 1 last night with a walk.
Nice cut.
Just missed it.
Yeah. See that ball going straight back as a pitcher, you're like, okay, need to switch something up here.
And the big thing, too, for Florida State is they can sit really one speed. You know, not a whole lot of off speed for Kirsten Deal. And Ross, good batting average, 326 against lefties, 4 home runs.
0-2 coming. Slow roller, foul ball. Brito tried to make it fair for a double play, but that was outside the line. Or just for the third out.
Remember, it's where the ball is. See, clearly foul.
Another 0-2 to Ross.
Good job by Hansen to jump up and get that.
I think Kirsten Deal, too, feeling like I got to get this really out of the zone. The last 0-2 pitch he threw was at the ankles of Ross, and she almost got to it.
It up, and that's trouble. In and out of the glove of Deal, and the bases are loaded.
That's a tough play with the corners playing back, the middles playing back, Deal's going after that. But to me, that is a play that needs to be made by one of the corners. The pitcher needs to stay as close as possible to the circle. In that situation, you can see that Sanders is going to come in and try and get it. Torres also behind, picking up the ball after it ricochets off. A tough, tough play. Probably needs to have a little bit more communication, but at times it's just important for that pitcher to stay a little bit closer to the circle.
Well, you don't want your pitcher diving, too. I mean,
yeah.
Well, this is one of the things that Patty Gasso was worried about. This is the MO for the Seminoles. Get people on base, get things stirred up, put some pressure on your defense. And this inning, a walk, an error, and an infield single. And now the pinch hitter, Katie Dack, to hit for Ashton Danley in the 9 spot in the order. As pitching coach Jen Rocha talks with Deal and the defense. The season, 3 home runs, 10 runs batted in. So Lonnie Alameda loves her analytics. You've got more pop in this bat, you got a better average. Going with Dak right here. Bases loaded, 2 down. Just her second appearance in the postseason. Katie's 0 for 1. There's what she's done on the season. Second year at Florida State after transferring over from Texas A&M. Great speed on the bases here for Florida State. Infield pop up and Sanders. Sanders is there, and that ends the threat. So both sides in the early going have left the base.
Status.
Yeah.
I'll show you my magenta status.
Okay, I'll just do it. Check out the T-Mobile Savings Calculator to see how much you can save. And right now, we'll even pay off your phone.
All right, let's run it through all seven NCAA championships. 2000 with Jennifer Stewart and Lisa Carey. 2013, Chamberlain's big home run. The Pages in 2016. Shea Knighton in 17 innings in 2017. G. Juarez in 21. They routed Texas in the finals in 2022. And then last year, capping off, Jordy Ball, the best season ever at 61-1 last year. And even more history as it continues to unfold. Last night, for Oklahoma, their 17th straight NCAA tournament win, which broke their record from 2017 and 18. So here tonight, they are looking to win their 18th straight game in the Regionals, Supers, and World Series after they ran the table last year in Oklahoma City to win a third straight national championship. Of course, nobody has won four in a row. UCLA and Arizona came close in the 80s and 90s, and there's a flare out to Mudge. Jada Coleman is retired, one down. McKenna Reed stays in to face the top of the order.
And I like the stuff, especially because, and we've mentioned this, McKenna Reed has not pitched in a month. She's battled through a ton this season. A lot of the pressure that she's felt, she's spinning it really good, mixing in the changeup. Biggest thing is avoiding barrels.
Well, that's key. If she can use that changeup effectively, right? Just missed hits, right? That's
yep.
All you need.
Don't need the swing and miss.
Well, and you know, we talk about that all the time. A lot of people focus on the swing and miss, the number of strikeouts. One pitch and two pitch outs are gifts from the softball gods. If you can get your outfield to put away most of the outs in the game, as long as you're staying in the yard, you're doing a good job.
Staying in the yard is the difficult part against yeah. this lineup, and one of the best in the country at it, Tiare Jennings. Got her to fly out in the first. Last night was her 95th career home run. That tied Lauren Chamberlain for second most at Oklahoma, third most in NCAA history.
You talk about being in a bubble. She was asked about it post-game, and she was like, what? I tied Lauren Chamberlain? Like, she had no idea. And so then her team all started hugging her and high-fiving. They didn't. And they just, yeah. They're not focused on that. It is definitely, truly about passing the bat.
And it was great that Lauren Chamberlain was here to see it.
Yeah.
Was that the game?
Goes the opposite way and knocks it through for a base hit.
And the thing I love about Tiare Jennings is she takes the pitch you give her. This is a single. This is a pitch off the plate. Look at how far outside that is, but she goes and gets it, and she drives it the opposite way. That is a single-only pitch. She doesn't try to hit a home run. She'd probably swing and miss it. She is just so good at identifying what she's given and taking advantage of it.
One on for Ella Parker. Singled out to left her first time up. And Jennings will take second. Wild pitch, charge to Reed. Ella now six hits in the NCAA tournament. Another one, that one got away from Edenfield, and Jennings takes third.
And that was more of a pass ball for
yeah.
sure.
Yep.
You know, going back to that hit by Jennings, is that's a two-strike, a 1-2 pitch. So as a pitcher, you're thinking, I'm going to put this in the river. I'm going to put this in the other batter's box. That's certainly far enough out of the zone, and with Jennings, it is not.
No. Her and Coleman both, the best bad ball hitters, yep. any ball hitters, bat on ball.
Well, especially low in the zone. You might be able to catch Tiare on a pitch, a rise ball, you know, up and off the plate. But when it's down, that's just down in her wheelhouse, and she can drop that barrel under the ball.
Hey, for the third straight year, the NCAA Division I Women's Lacrosse National Championship game will be on ESPN. Sunday at noon Eastern, we'll have the women's final for you. We know Northwestern is into the championship game, still awaiting word on Syracuse or Boston College for the championship. We are scoreless here, but Oklahoma threatening. Go ahead run at third. With one out here in the top of the third.
Edenfield struggling right now. It's a third in a row that's just popped out of her glove. And very uncharacteristic for her behind the plate.
And we talk a lot about pitchers and the effect of not having thrown for a month, but also what about the catcher, right? Not used to the spin, the way the ball comes in, a little bit different in velocity. So all those things make a difference when your pitcher hasn't really been in a game situation for over a month. It affects your battery, the whole battery.
So now in the game, two hits and three walks for Oklahoma. And I think a timing violation may have just been called on Alyssa Brito for not being in the batter's box on time with the pitch clock.
It was.
So the count starts out 0-1. Edenfield, the throw down to second. A run down with Parker, and they're going to get the tag. The throw to the plate, though, will not be in time. And Oklahoma generates a run with Jennings coming in.
This is some old school softball. When was the last time you saw a first and third run down to try to get the runner at third base? Perfectly executed by Oklahoma, especially for Ella Parker to stay in this, be able to get the rundown to go back to second base. That is the key. Flaherty should have kept her going to get the out, but once she got a Meyer Ross going away from home plate, Jennings was going to score. You practice those all the time, but rarely does it happen in a game.
So 1-0 Sooners. Three and one, I believe, is the count that the home plate umpire just put up. And now they've corrected it on the scoreboard here. So 3-1 to Brito. Full count.
Brito wanted that. A little off speed up in the zone. A miss from Reed. Brito knew it. Her eyes got big. She took a hack. Two home runs yesterday for her and a double off the wall. She's feeling it.
Walked earlier tonight. And walks again. Fourth of the game and back-to-back now for McKenna Reed. And it is an empty bullpen right now for Florida State. As Cassidy Pickering steps in. First pitch swinging and back onto the roof. The National Freshman of the Year list has been pared down to three, but when it was at 25, Pickering was on it.
I'm sure she'd be on a top five as well. A lot of good freshman performances. Jason Beecham is one of the top three finalists, along with Ella Parker, both in this game.
Inside, 1-1. .383 with runners on base this season for Cassidy. And they seem to be having an issue right now with the texture of the softballs here, the grip of the softballs.
sometimes new balls get thrown into the game and they're not rubbed up.
Looks like Reed's got one she likes. Again, down in the dirt. And Edenfield's got to scramble for it. Fouled off. Boy, you know, we've talked about the issues with the pitching staff. We saw the leadership last night from Edenfield and the job that she has working with so many different arms who throw so many different types of pitches and also reliant, as we've talked about, on the freshmen this year. Outstanding job back there.
And you're catching every game, so there's probably not a lot of bullpen time for you to save your knees, save your legs.
And Reed gets a strikeout. Side retired, but a run in. Some super regional storylines for you. Florida continues to stay hot. They rallied to beat Baylor today. Jocelyn Erickson, another big game. Duke winning its first ever super regional game, and they are one win away from their first trip to the Women's College World Series. They'll play again tomorrow. And the headline so far today, Texas A&M with a shocker over the number one seed, Texas. At one point, that game was 6-0. So they win game one, and now A&M can eliminate Texas in game two tomorrow. Our story here, Oklahoma, a winner in game one last night, so Florida State has to win here tonight, or else the Sooners move on and punch that first ticket to OKC.
It's always interesting this time of year, decisions like which pitchers are starting which games, especially when you have a more or less defined ace, like Texas A&M has with Emily Kennedy, and same thing with Florida. Rothrock, does she come back in game two? Do they go to Ava Brown? What does Texas A&M do? Do they come right back with Kennedy? Or?
Yeah, Duke could come right back with Jayla Wright.
Yep.
Only threw a couple of innings today.
Cassidy
Keep
Curd.
Keep your foot
good.
On the pedal. That's what I say. Don't get too crazy. Go for it. Just game go two. For it. Yeah. Don't think, oh, it's a three-game series. We might need our ace and get, no.
And if she gets in trouble early, then you adjust accordingly. But if you can keep your ace out there, get a lead.
And get that extra day to prepare for the World Series.
Yeah, for sure.
Winning two instead of three. I believe the number is 81%. If you win game one of the Supers, you win the Super and go to the World Series. So the numbers favor that first game winner. 3-1 to Beecham. She gets a hold of one. Back it goes and gone. Jason E. Beecham ties it up.
The freshman just moved up to this leadoff position, by the way, in this game to really pack a punch at the top. Lonnie Almeida not going more traditional lefty speed. She was going more for the power and the punch. This one up in the zone, 3-1 pitch, and she's hunting. Meets this even. It got out of here real fast.
16th home run of the year for Beecham.
Well, tied up.
Setting some records.
She had the best freshman batting average in the country. She packs a wallop. The freshman RBI record holder already at FSU, and now a 1-1 game on her solo home run. And she'll pass the bat to the senior, Harding. The big season continues for Beecham. And Jessica Mendoza, we have a blue tape chest protector update for America. Go.
Well, the color, I was talking to JT Gasso before the game, and something that this team had worked up on was for the pitchers, what the color does for their breath, how it calms them. blue is for the in-breath person that wants to breathe in, take it in. The red that you'll see changed out for some of their pitchers is about breathing out, just to help calm and trigger.
So there you go, Mary. You can play at home, America. Are you in a pressure situation or a big moment, are you taking a deep breath or are you
exhaling? That's what it's about.
Blue tape, red tape.
It says a lot about your personality. I'm a red tape, turns out.
I'd want both.
She's purple.
Oh, well, that's because you root for the Mets and the Yankees simultaneously, right. So of course you want both. So there you go. That's why sometimes you see the red tape, sometimes you see the blue tape, horizontal or vertical. There is a look at the bullpen. Still plenty of activity for the Sooners. Patty Gasso tapping those fingers. What a run it has been. 30 seasons. She is a Hall of Famer. She is number one amongst active coaches and wins. Another national championship would tire with the legendary coach Mike Candrea. 8 natties at Arizona. That's the most for a single coach. Of course, UCLA has more, but that national championship split amongst their 3 coaches and 2 Hall of Famers. And Sue Enquist and Sharon Backus. Bruins looked good against Georgia last night. Mm-hmm. They could punch a ticket later tonight under Kelly Eye. Then a smoking hot Maya Brady bat right now.
How about the freshman pitcher, KT, Caitlin Terry?
She's been on your radar all year.
Has been, yeah.
They have a similar story as Florida State. Really struggled early. Totally different team second half of the season. And that's the story for the Noles as well. Two to Harding.
Good job, Harding, waiting on that changeup. Wasn't fooled by it at all. Fouled it straight back. That's another changeup. So the one prior, she fouled back 56 miles an hour. That one comes in at 58. Harding's still not fooled by it. Takes it the opposite way. You can see it's elevated, gets up in the eyes, just hammers it the opposite way.
Tough to get a change by her when she's batting 500 on that pitch. And that is the go-ahead run now for Florida State, trying to save their season tonight. And force a game 3 tomorrow. Here's Edenfield. Been playing, the last month to 6 weeks with that finger wrapped up after a self-inflicted finger injury this year.
She's swinging the bat basically 7-8 fingers. I mean, it's top 2 on that top hand, not even on the bat. That's how she's been attacked, is a lot inside, really hard to get to that pitch.
She's a producer. With a very good eye. It was 3 walks yesterday, and now a 3-0 count here. Starting to set just beyond the left field bleachers. And that's in for a strike. Fly ball, Pickering. One down. Issa Torres, a fly out to right field back in the second inning. Out of Georgetown, Texas. The two freshmen, Torres and Beecham, two of the top three hitters this season for Florida State. And Patty Gasso out to talk to Kirsten Deal. Are they ready to make a move? Door opening out of the bullpen. And it's Carly Keeney coming on. Grad student transfer from Liberty. With four straight lefties coming up. And a tape change as well, ladies. We'll let that unfold during the commercial break. Back in a moment.
GEICO covers dead batteries with their easy app and 24/7 help.
You've reached the dead end, monster!
No kidding. Dead batteries are the worst. But no worries. GEICO gives me even more coverage and 24/7 help. See?
Wait a second. You're not Frankenstein's monster.
No. That's his cousin Trevor.
Did you try the spooky castle up the road?
Good idea. Thanks. You folks have a great evening.
Season in her relief appearances. And she was a big part of Liberty's stunning upset of UCLA last year in the NCAA tournament. One inning of work in the regionals, as you see the numbers for Kirsten Deal through 52 pitches today. Just the one free pass and the one home run ball to Jasoni Beecham earlier this inning. So Keeney comes on with a runner on first and one out. And facing Issa Torres. Interesting move here because it's four lefties coming up now against the righty.
Yeah, you would think that you would want Deal, the lefty, in to face those four lefties in a row. But it almost seems like Patty Gasso is challenging her pitchers. She said that earlier in the year. She's like, I need my pitching staff to step up, and I'm going to challenge them to be better. Better in the free passes department, better keeping the ball in the yard. Keeney does roll a lot of ground balls. Maybe looking to use that defense a little more.
Looking for a double play ball here. Just the one hit through the first couple of innings, and now a pair here in the third. Harding over at first base following her single.
Has done a good job of keeping the ball in the yard. She's only given up five home runs this year. However, three of those were to Miami of Ohio in the first weekend this park was open.
Another one that Hansen has to block, 2-2. Torres 2-for-8. In the NCAA tournament with a runner on base. Gets under that. Riley Boone. Two down. And that'll bring up Devin Flaherty, a fly ball out to center back in the second. In her fifth year, dating back to the COVID season. Over 270 career games, guys. Only Skylar Wallace at Florida has played more amongst the active players. Skyler and the Gators picked up a win over Baylor today. Game one of their Super. Flaherty, ground ball, Jennings chooses to go to first. Side retired, but the Beecham bomb evens the score through three.
They're able to use so many different pitchers now. Fifth coming in and Mimi Gooden. What's the plan now moving forward?
Mixed speeds, mixed locations, try to keep them off balance, keep having fun. That's the plan.
And coach, what kind of I assume it's a joy to coach Beecham. I mean, she ties up the game for you. What is that freshman like?
Yeah, she's awesome. I know we spoke a couple days ago, but you know, she's been coming to games since she's been wee little. I know she's still wee little, but she's an awesome kid, and she just loves playing softball and just raises the joy for all of us.
Thank you so much, Lonnie.
Thank you, guys.
So Mimi Gooden, the freshman righty out of Milton, Florida, who was 1-0, picked up a win over UCF in the regional, now making her super regional debut. Please, and there are the numbers on Mimi with the 24 appearances, a 4.25 ERA. She throws a lot of the drop ball and the curve and screwball to move it around. And a tough spot to step into right here facing Kinsey Hansen, the All-American.
She had a great start last weekend in regionals against UCF, really at a time when Florida State needed her to step up.
Kinsey grounded a third, her first time up. A hot shot off the glove of Gooden to Torres at short. And with the time to get her at first base. Great reaction at short by Issa. And by Gooden to get a piece of that.
That ball is hit hard right back at Gooden. It's going to go off of her glove. It's hard to defend yourself when you're coming out of the pitch, but I love the way Torres is going to go get that and shows off her arm again. Not a lot of time. Quick transfer from glove to throwing arm and getting that across the infield.
Quick but calm.
Mm-hmm.
So the pattern here tonight for Florida State, bring in a new arm and see if you can mow through the bottom of the order. They did that in the second inning, got a 1-2-3 inning. And now they're trying to steal another one here in the fourth.
And this is something that Oregon also did last weekend. And Patty Gasso talked about it with her hitters that, you know, you're facing basically one pitcher in at bat, and you're trying to adjust and communicate. And it's really something you're not used to. Usually use that first at bat to adjust.
And boom, knocks one through the right side.
Look at her asking for the fans.
Wow.
You gotta love it. Turned around the stadium, packed house, and give me some love for this single. Patty Gasso calls her the creator of chaos, who saw the drag buns in short game yesterday, and this just did not get another runner on base.
So she got a promotion. She used to be the party starter
in the nine
hole.
And
now she's the creator of chaos in the seven hole. And here's Alina Torres. Pulled back on the bunt and takes strike one.
Yeah, so Patty Gasso basically said she was in that nine hole hitting 400 and really was not coming up in a position where anyone was on base. She's like, we need to use her and that great batting average to hit people in. Well, granted, she was second up in this inning.
Torres golfs that one out to Kerr in center. Two down. Oklahoma now 1-for-6 with runners on base tonight. Their only run scored in the third inning when Ella Parker got the first and third play to work to score T.R.A. Jennings. Here's Sanders. They've also let four walks fall by the wayside tonight. Two in the first, two in the third that did not make it home.
be interesting to see if they send Boone with two outs. Edenfield's only thrown out three base stealers.
Oh, hit and run on, and skied out to Kerr again. End of the inning, so Boone's single, and she's stranded out there. As we go to the bottom of the fourth, Patty Gasso on the head.
They're putting good swings on, hitting high, hitting hard. We're going to get there. I'm confident in that. We're there. We're right there.
And, Coach, you made the switch from Deal to Keeney when there were four straight lefties up for Florida State. We're just, I'm kind of curious. Want to get in the
mind. Okay, lefty. I see lefty.
That's right. That's right.
It's matchups and needing balls on the ground. And Keeney's good for that. So we needed to keep the ball in the park and let our infield work.
Awesome. All right, thank you very much, Patty.
Sorry, left.
Thanks, Coach. Oh.
Should have asked her if she's red or blue. Beth Mullins, along with Jessica Mendoza and Michelle Smith. I don't think anybody loves lefties more than Michelle Smith or Patty Gasso. How about the Sooner Southpaws? This list of All-Americans that were also national champions. For the longest time, it was only lefties that were winning titles with G and Paige Parker, Kehlani Ricketts. Jennifer Stewart started it all. That's actually 2000 for Stewart. That was their very first championship. Took them a while to get back to the top, and now they've won six in the last 10 years with eight trips to the finals in the last 11 years. The Sooner Dynasty. And all unfolding in the house that Patty built here at Love's Field. Mudge, good swing for the base hit out to left. And the leadoff aboard, the go-ahead aboard now for FSU in the bottom of the fourth.
That's got to feel so good for that senior. She's been batting leadoff all season long, got bumped down because she has been struggling. They go for a pinch runner. The left ankle's been still bugging her even after the surgery she had in the offseason. So
that's her first hit of the NCAA tournament, so Mudge does break through. She can re-enter defensively. That's Autumn Belvine. And Janai Kerr will come up. I know the softball world sending a lot of love and whatever they can to help support Autumn Belvi and Josie Muffley, the Tornadoes that recently, a couple of weeks ago, blew through Tallahassee. She was away with the team at the ACC tournament. Reports are that a tree actually fell into their home. The extended family in Tallahassee around Seminole softball that Lani Alameda has helped build over the course of the last 16 seasons. Here's an 0-2 to Kerr, got a piece. Kerr, the fourth batter that Carly Keeney has faced tonight after she came on in relief last inning. Belvi able to run on the off speed and swipe the bag.
Oh, that makes me wonder if they have that picked, because that's an 0-2 count. It's not a great run count, but obviously it is when you know something slow is coming, something that's been showing up in the dirt.
Runner in scoring position now for Janai. Waits on that change, and it's right to third, and Brito is there, one down. Jasoni Beecham looks on. She's responsible for the Florida State run, the solo home run to lead off the third inning. As Amaya Ross steps in, bottom of the order here for the Seminoles. Thank you.
Ross, shallow left. Jennings has it, two down.
It's interesting, Keeney comes into this, gets a lot of ground ball outs, but it's been a lot of fly balls. Three of the four outs have been in the air. Mm-hmm. The goal, though, is just keep it in the yard. When Oklahoma gets beat, it's giving up the long ball, and Keeney has not been a part of that.
Well, Keeney did make it through the gauntlet of lefties, and now a run of righties coming up with Ross, and here's Dak at a slow roll. Sanders has it. Single for Mudge, but the base runner stranded. 1-1.
Has it ever tasted like our McMuffin? Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
We're living in a world that no one knows right now. No one has experienced it. A fourth straight national championship, it's almost unheard of. If they can raise that trophy one more time, they would be the undisputed greatest class over the last 4 years that I think college softball may ever see.
And what a run it has been. 228 and 14 is their record. That's a 92% win percentage, over 300 homers, 1,200 RBIs. The three national championships going for an unprecedented fourth title. Last year, the best record in the history of the sport at 61-1. And Coleman, one of those seniors, right on cue, off the glove of Flaherty. And the go-ahead aboard for OU. And another senior to follow her.
Look at that smile. OU is best when they're in attack mode. First pitch, Shane Coleman, watch the eyes just get big. And the swing, flat. Nice effort by Flaherty, but this ball was smoked.
We've had some awfully good combos at the top of lineups in the last 40 plus years of the game. I don't know if there's been a whole lot better than these two. As Jennings has moved back into the two spot here.
Back to back, they're hard to pitch to. One's right, one's left. So it's not like you can throw someone in situationally. If they were both lefty or both righty.
Yeah. Very different styles of hitting too. Yeah.
There's two ways it can go, right? When you're trying to do something that's never been done, you can, you know, cower at the bottom of that hill, or you can lace up your hiking boots and have at it. And these two are hiking.
High shot to Flaherty, who's right there. One down.
Great job by Flaherty and her positioning. It's a big part of Florida State's game. It's not just the pitch calling from Lonnie Alameda. It's also where they put their defenders.
What these seniors are trying to do is join a very select group of other student athletes over the years that have won four consecutive national championships. Most recently, UConn basketball. As Ella Parker steps in. Seniors would love to be a part of this list.
Wow.
Going back to Mia Hamm, Stewie at UConn, Ariel Wilson at Penn State, Jen Adams, Maryland. Courtney Kuppitz, the gymnast.
Greatness in female college athletics. And that list alone. And then what they went on to accomplish after college.
Those were some of the notables. Of course, before Twitter blows up, there were others. Parker, down the line, fair ball. Coleman doesn't hesitate. The throw to third, not in time. As she slides by Beecham into the bag. Runners at first and third.
Look at Patty Gasso. You had me scared. You coming all the way around. Ella Parker, freshman, gets the ball up in the zone. She stays up and through, gets this down the line. But Jada Coleman does not hesitate at all. She is aggressive.
aggressive at the plate. She is aggressive on the base paths, gets to third base. Freshman to senior. That's how they do it here at Norman.
And I have to say, that was an impressive throw by Harding out in right field, because she was... That was a long
almost
throw.
Almost got her.
And almost got her, especially with Coleman's speed.
So now a chance for the Sooners to jump in front. Brito has walked twice, hitting in the fourth spot in the order. Gooden sends it way outside. A couple of singles in the inning for OU. Upstairs.
Interesting here too, with Brito being a righty, that now situationally Florida State was playing a little bit deeper with their middles, trying to turn a potential double play to get out of the inning. Earlier in the game with left-handed hitters in this situation, they had the defense pulled in.
Are we going to see a third pitching change of the night? Got a couple of bodies running in from the bullpen. I don't see anybody with their glove.
I think you're going over first and third. That's the one run that's been scored was just a mix-up on how to handle one of the simplest plays in softball. So runners at first and third here. Lonnie going over with her defense, making sure everyone's on the same page. That's why this isn't a pitcher's conversation.
That was Danley, by the way, that did have her glove. She can re-enter. But they will stick with the freshman. And the biggest inning of her young career, Mimi Gooden.
And it will be interesting to see if they do try to send Parker to alleviate the pressure of a double play. Parker does have a lot of speed, 16 stolen bases on the year.
First and third is what scored the run in the third inning. Brito, wild pitch. Here comes Coleman to the plate, and Oklahoma grabs the lead.
Interesting pitch by Gooden. Doesn't even come close to anywhere around that Edenfield can even try to attempt. Look at how she short arms this, and that ball is beyond the left batter's box. So really just short arming her arm circle.
Parker advanced to second. Torres is there at short, two down. So both Oklahoma runs, ironically enough, tonight come in without a hit.
Now I think she's making the change.
And Gooden will come out. And Danley, who started, will re-enter.
A tough situation at times for Danley, who obviously starts the game, comes out, but has to stay warm, knowing at some point she will be re-entered into the game. A fine line of staying warm and not losing your legs in the pen.
She was a starter yesterday as well, so most familiar pitcher for the Sooner team.
56 pitches yesterday. Two innings of work.
And so let's see, Smitty, let's go through with her in that flex position. Does that mean Reed and Gooden now are burnt?
That's correct.
So those two could not re-enter here in the top of the fifth. NCAA men's lacrosse semifinals are coming your way Saturday here on ESPN2. At noon Eastern, it's Denver and Notre Dame. The Fighting Irish try and go back-to-back
followed at 2:30 by Maryland and Virginia. The final Monday afternoon on ESPN at 1 Eastern. Oklahoma has taken the lead. And on the wild pitch, Jada Coleman coming home. And now it's back to Ashton Denley. Started the game through an inning, one hit, walked a couple, faced six batters. Gorgeous night here in Norman.
She got out of that bases loaded jam. And to get two more outs, not easy to do against Oklahoma.
Two outs here, she'll face the number five hitter, Cassidy Pickering. First pitch in the dirt. She got Cassidy to pop up to short in the first, and then Pickering struck out in the third. Facing Reed.
I got her strike out actually on a pitch that was in. She's a little bit more off the plate now.
Up and in. 2-1. RBI opportunity with Ella Parker down at second. Last night, Kinzie Hansen. Oklahoma moving closer to that first Women's College World Series bid of the weekend. And Pickering reliving it.
She's out of breath, too. She went around the bases yelling, jumping, screaming.
Somebody put some tape on. Boy, these two freshmen, what an impact. With her and Parker. Similar to what Beecham and Torres have been able to do for Florida State this year.
Hansen taking a change up there. The change up she hit out last night.
It's another. Shake of the head from Patty. Trying to jam her. Full count.
Yeah, you see back-to-back changeups like that. And you come in lefty on right. That's
Hansen. lashes that through the left side. Fourth hit of the inning for the Sooners.
They're just like a machine. Once they start, they're hard to stop. You get that momentum built up, and it's hard to close the door on them.
Everyone wants a piece.
Here's Riley Boone. Singled her last time up. It's almost a sense we've talked about this throughout the year with senior classes around the country, and can you crank it back up late in the season? Losing Bedlam here at home, starting to look more like a wake-up call for this group. They've looked like a different team. They beat Texas to win the Big 12 tournament. Flaherty will apply the tag to get the final out, but three runs in for Oklahoma. Doing it with a dinger.
It's everything.
Here's our NCAA Softball Super Regional Saturday for you on ESPN. We'll get things going at 11 a.m. Eastern. And then all day long for you, Florida can advance to the World Series. So can Duke and Tennessee and Texas A&M, the stunner over Texas today. If we have an if necessary game, it'll be tomorrow night on ESPN at 7 Eastern. And then we head to Stillwater and out west for the night games, UCLA. That would be an if necessary if Georgia wins later this evening. So we could start punching, well, a couple of tickets tonight as this score stands. Oklahoma advances. Florida State still with time, still with outs, still with opportunities, and still with Jason E. Beecham, who hit the solo home run in the third. Top of the order coming up for the Seminoles. Can they respond to the three spot from OU? That one's high. One, no, two and one. So Riley Boone, the left fielder, has moved over to right. Hannah Kaur comes on to play left. Changes defensively for the Sooners. Jason, he grounded out her first time up. How you guys handicapping that Rookie of the Year race? You know, she's got huge numbers. Yeah. Keegan Rothrock, the pitcher, had a big win today. She's been fabulous for that Florida staff, and of course Parker for OU.
I'd give it to Beecham, but I think they should also have a freshman pitcher of the year.
Oh, that's a good idea.
And player, pitcher should
player
just be separated.
Yeah. Listen now.
Beecham gets a hold of another one. Back that goes. She had one of those last year in the championship series.
Can we just talk about the athleticism of this play? The timing of it to jump up and rob a home run, Jada Coleman. And you guys, this place erupted louder than any. The senior. Wow.
Wow. I mean, and she's not played many games in this park. That's
no.
The other part that's impressive. They're still learning the depth of this park, the way the ball flies in this park.
And to be able to do that in what may be your last game you'll ever play in Norman as a Sooner. If they win, they advance to OKC in these seniors. Cool.
And think about what she's done offensively with the bat. We saw her take first to third on the base pass, but that catch right there, the reaction to this crowd and taking away a home run.
Boy, they are hitting Keeney hard right now.
I mean, that grin's not going to leave her face for a week.
And did you see her? She was just giving kudos to Cora, saying, I could hear you talking to me.
Yep.
That's awesome.
It's in for a strike, 2-2, but there are a lot of pitches coming across the plate, letter high right now.
I mean, the degree of difficulty, I'm going to talk about this catch the whole inning. There were so many factors.
Hold on, are center fielders better than left fielders?
I think she's saying
Let's discuss. One of the greatest ever in left, Jessica Mendoza.
Played center in college. Just saying outfielders, period.
Two sports star. Full count. Harding down the line, headed for the pole, and fair. Solo. That may still be going.
Wow. That ball was mashed. Kaylee Harden with her 15th home run of the year, taking a pitch that I think a lot of people thought was foul, but it was clearly fair. I mean, and that one over the stands, this ball up and in, and Harding just rotates on this and just drives that out of the park.
She just took the glove out of all the outfielders' hands on that one. Nobody going to get to it.
And Patty's thinking about, I think, asking for a review.
I mean, both home plate and third base umps.
The fans in left field
clearly pointing.
Well, I don't know if it's
fair.
Reviewable because it was above the foul pole.
That might be what they're talking about right now with the umpires.
That's a fair ball. It's going over the stands, and the stands are obviously in fair territory, so.
Let's see if we get a look at it here.
Oof.
Oh, maybe.
That's close.
Yeah, so that one, it looks a little different.
In time to get Edenfield. Two down.
You know Brito's got some basketball in her. I mean, that was straight up hops. Getting to that play. It's two defensive gems. The outs haven't been easy.
Here's Torres. In a 4-2 game, which was almost 4-3.
Wow.
Coleman catch looks even bigger.
Yeah.
And Kaylee Harding hit one farther than anybody else in the tournament so far, perhaps. That was launched.
Yeah, they got to measure that one because couldn't see where it landed.
Senior trying to extend her career at Florida State. They've been such a special group. Lonnie Alameda likes to call them the most decorated with what they've done at the World Series and in ACC play. They arrived shortly after the national championship season. Played through the COVID, and they are swinging it right now. Torres heading for second. Stand up double. They are tagging Keeney right now.
everything has been hard hit. This is a beautiful job by the freshman. She hits it off her back leg. She's making sure against this pitch that she is waiting as long as possible. Hannah Kaur trying to dive. No chance to really cut that off either way.
Yeah. At some point, Oklahoma's going to need to make a move because there's just been too many balls hit hard in a row. Not fooling this lineup.
Wait, now you got the experienced bats of the seniors back-to-back here in Flaherty and Mudge. As Rocha talks to the Sooners, the Seminoles trying to stir things up a little bit. Kaylee Mudge, who singled her last time up. That's Kelly Maxwell, the starter last night. Out there with G. Juarez standing nearby. Twice reaching the championship series against Oklahoma. They are trying to avoid a third OU elimination in their 4 years. But they reached the final as a 6 seed. They reached the finals as a 10 seed. They have overcome adversity and have played their best at these moments. Ground ball to the right side, and that will end it. What?
Check your blind spot.
Take delicious Little Caesar's Crazy Puffs anywhere for the incredible price of only $3.99.
Pizza, pizza.
CAA Finals Division I Women's Softball. There it is. This is going to be a bam bammer. Oh, and she's safe. A great effort. UCLA Bruins are the champ. Isn't that what it's all about, folks?
Oh, that was indeed a bam bammer back when this all started. NCAA softball 1982. Debbie Dew.
Wow.
Dot Richardson siding
yes.
In that one.
Mm-hmm.
UCLA. Hey, speaking of the Bruins, they're coming up. Against Georgia, they have just gotten underway. You can find them on your ESPN app. All the games this weekend available on your ESPN app. Got a 4-2 game, Oklahoma in front of Florida State. As we head to the sixth inning, OU 6 outs away from grabbing that first spot at the Women's College World Series, which gets underway next Thursday with a quadruple header, one of the great days in softball.
Sooners know too, they got to put up some more runs. For Florida State, they will have the top of their order, not next inning, but for the seventh. That's been the run producers, the big boppers.
Ashton Danley started, pitched the first inning, came back in the fifth, and now back out there for the sixth. Was greeted by the Cassidy Pickering two-run home run and then retired. We got that final out to end the fifth. So it's 8-9, and then the top, Torres grounds it to Flaherty. One down.
This is the only part of the Sooner order that doesn't have a hit. Yeah, Torres and Sanders back up to the top.
Sanders popped to first, flew out to left. Another one in the dirt from Danley. Sid, by the way, last year in that championship series, did hit a home run against Florida State. That was in game two when they clinched it 3-1.
When that changeup goes away on Ashton, it goes away where it's not even a competitive pitch. Popping it in a couple times.
Three and 0 to Sid, and then the top of the order comes back up. Walks on four pitches. That's what she does. She's got more free passes than hits this year. Probably get lifted for a pinch runner, and it's the top of the order that generated the three runs in the fifth. Walked in the first, flew out in the third, singled and scored in the fifth. Seniors with so much on their plate right now, just finishing up school, thinking about the future, thinking about their softball careers. Jada also thinking about her wedding that's coming up.
Gonna run through the box and slap.
Got all the tools.
Haven't seen that in a while.
Drag butt. The first pitch of this, too. Mixing it up.
Working on the short game.
Quiet through the first four and making noise. Last time through the order. Jennings, Flaherty with a nice play at second. Gets the out at first. Goes down in the dirt. Stole a single there, two down.
Fantastic play. We've seen her take away a few hits in this series. This ball hits so hard, it almost takes her into right field with her. Goes down to the knees, stays with it, under control. Her pitcher, Danley. Pumped.
Bland does move over to second, so with two outs, a runner in scoring position. And here's T.R.A. Jennings, and not gonna let her swing.
Hello with the reaction. A lot of times you don't see walking the two-hole hitter to get to the three-hole hitter, but this is T.R.A. Jennings, and I like the call. Ella Parker is a great, fantastic hitter as a freshman on deck, but T.R.A. is the best hitter in this lineup.
Come on, you have the lefty-lefty matchup up with Parker. Jennings just sees lefty as well. We could keep going on the checklist still. Why it's a good idea.
It's probably the first time in Parker's life she's been walked to get to her.
Yeah, exactly.
One of the top freshmen in this year's class, a top five recruit. And look at Jennings immediately turns to talk to the youngster. Umpire's going to get together to talk about it. was Danley able to fake Bland out?
I don't know what she was thinking.
No, I think she thought that she could, since Danley is out of the circle, she thinks nobody's at third, but they're clearly, right, Beecham is at third. That is just a base running error by Bland.
I don't think there's anything to talk about.
Mm-mm.
The call on the field is an out. Play under review is obstruction at second base.
Boy, this could be huge with Parker coming up and all two on base.
Heads up play by Danley to notice that Land was off the bag, and then for Flaherty to be behind and also Beecham to be at the bag.
The throw, once she catches it, she's allowed to be in that lane to follow the ball. So before the throw, she was blocking the bag.
Yeah, so Bland just takes off seeing that Danley was out of the circle.
After reviewing the play, the call on the field has changed. There will be obstruction at second base. First and second, two outs.
Wow, that's a big
first challenge by Oklahoma.
Well, Patty Gasso, that's a huge sigh of relief, and I think that's what they're talking about. Telling her, let's go, let's be smart, because she was definitely out either way, but Flaherty, you see, before she gets to the ball, she's blocking the bag.
That's actually Torres, the shortstop, who was backing up.
Well, I think part of it, too, is the throw took her towards center field.
So back to two on with two out and a chance for Parker now after the intentional walk to T.R.A. Jennings. Singled in the first, walked in the third, singled again and scored in the fifth on the Pickering home run. High 3-0. Was the Rook have the green light. Takes. Ball four, the bases are loaded for Alyssa Brito. Had the two home runs last night.
The clock ran down. That infield smart. She called timeout right before it hit zero.
In for a strike.
Kayla Edenfield's MVP for this team. Her being able to notice all the different things, catch five different pitchers.
Way up. 1-1. In for a strike. 1-2. Bland at third, Jennings at second, Parker at first. They left the bases loaded without a run in back in the first inning. Trying to avoid that fate in the sixth. That too was against Danley, who worked out of the jam.
Gotta be careful with Brito inside right now.
They don't go there, full count.
Two changeups in a row.
Our traditional quadruple header to open up the tournament starts at noon Eastern on ESPN. For more information about the World Series, go to NCAA.com, the official online home for all 90 NCAA championships. 4-2 the score, Oklahoma with the lead over Florida State. As the score stands, the Sooners would pick up the first bid to the Women's College World Series. Florida State still with a couple of chances to change that. A must-win situation for the Noles if they rally. We've got a game three back here tomorrow night in prime time on ESPN. Nicole May is the new pitcher. Third of the night for the Sooners. Avery Hodge is also in at second base. And for Florida State, Mudge has re-entered, so she is leading off the sixth. 6-7-8 coming up. Nicole May, the senior out of Pleasanton, California, went 2-0 in the regionals with wins over Cleveland State and Oregon. In her Oklahoma career, she is 61-5, the second best win percentage in school history. And another member of this senior class would maybe playing in its final home game in Norman tonight. It's Mudge to swing and miss, 1-2. And for Kaylee Mudge, trying to get her and her teammates more at-bats. Senior trying to keep her career going before she heads off to nursing school, I believe. It up, but oh, what a diving play by Sydney Sanders! Another web gem for the Sooners. The full layout.
We talk a lot about the offense for this Oklahoma team, but consistently one of the best defensive teams in the country. Sanders coming in, laying out,
Love the way that she identifies this. Glove open, gets it underneath there. And then look at the Superman slide. Look at her. She's got hands up. Superman slide.
Well, oh, me?
Right at her again. Sanders handles it. Two down as we get you to the studio for an update. Thank you very much. So UCLA jumping in front. Also LSU, a good start. A three-run first inning against Stanford tonight.
A lot of surprises. Yeah.
That's mayhem.
Yeah, it is mayhem. You could just kind of feel it from the first week of the season that this was going to be a special season.
Oh, yeah. Number one, Texas lost today in their opener. Number 10, Duke won at number 7, Missouri today in their game one.
I think for the first time in a long time, any 1 through 16 seeds could potentially beat anybody.
One-two pitch from Nicole May. Tapper right back to her. And a 1-2-3 inning. Sooners with the 2-run lead, 3 outs away.
For the love of football. For the love of the FA Cup.
All right, let's take a look at tonight's Capital One rewarding performance. Ladesman, the outfielders, Cassidy Pickering, your right fielder, goes yard for a 2-run home run. That's the 2-run lead, but it's been the catch of Jada Coleman in center field, taking one away. You're talking outfield, 3 runs. Everybody else, 0. Coleman and Pickering, that has been the catch of the year. Taking away the home run, and Pickering, who is leading us up right now, the big blast.
Seven coming up. Left fielder out there for the Seminoles, Kennedy Harp, freshman from Lawrenceville, Georgia. Knowles are looking for a 1-2-3 inning, and then in the bottom of the 7th, 9-1-2 are due up. That would include Beecham and Harding. The freshman who hit the home run and the senior who hit the other home run. Off speed is high, full count.
Top of the 7th for the Sooners.
Great job of hip hand separation. You can see she clears the hips. That's why she's got her front toe pointed open. When she clears them, that hands follow. Barrel to an inside pitch.
couple of ground outs and then a single. Hanson chops it to Torres. Flaherty for one over to first. They'll just get the lead, one down. And it's Riley Boone. So far off of the plate for that inside pitch. Danley's been working that backdoor curveball inside to lefties. Look how far back in the box she is. Thought about the drag. It's not a bad idea. Amaya Ross is back at first base.
Boone's always looking. She gets in that batter's box and she's just analyzing. All right, where can I get my hit?
Another one of those seniors out of Owosso, Oklahoma. Her fifth season. She's been so clutch, the steady improvement over the years.
One homegrown, too. Yeah, that's something Patty is proud of. Stay in the state.
Full count. To Flaherty. Only play is to first. Hanson over to second. Two down. And it's Avery Hodge coming up. Avery's looking for her first hit of this NCAA tournament. Been splitting time with Torres at second base.
Her first at bat this series. It's been all Torres. Usually they kind of flip-flop. Torres had a great game last night.
And hit by the pitch. Curveball in the inner half. Basically the look of that pitch, like it's going to hit you, and obviously on ones like that it does hit you because it's not bended back into the zone. Sid Sanders, who had the pair of nice defensive plays that last half inning.
Just kind of hold your breath as a Sooner fan. You're just waiting for her to get that shot. 13 home runs on the season. It's been a quiet bat. Every swing she takes, there's a chance.
27 hits on the year. 13 are home runs. Smitty, that's nearly 50%.
Look at her math skills. So impressed.
Nearly. I like that. Looking at 0-2, though, right here. Makes the catch, and it's the last chance coming for Florida State. They need a couple as we head to the bottom of the seventh. 10 years trying to win that fourth straight natty, and for Florida State and this fabulous senior class that has propelled them, they need a win. They need a rally to force a game three, so they're looking at least two to tie, or can they walk it off? They've got their big hitters coming around. Hallie Wakehaser is going to be the pinch hitter here at the bottom of the order. And then Beecham and Harding and Edenfield would be next at the top. Beecham and Harding both have home runs tonight. And they will have to try and beat Nicole May to do it. Wakehaser, 275 hitter on the year. Takes a look at strike one. This is the second inning of work for Nicole May. Set down the side in order in the sixth inning. Wakehaser, ground ball to Hodge, one down. And how do you pitch now to Beecham? And Harding,
carefully. Very carefully. Well, obviously, you have to go at Beecham. She's the one you don't want to let on base.
Jason, he hit one out, and then another one was going out, and Jada Coleman brought it back in out in center field.
Yeah, it was a crush line drive.
So she hit the home run on a 3-1 count. The one that almost went out that Coleman pulled back in was a 3-2 count. So the key is you don't want to get behind.
One and one.
Didn't want it outside. Look at middle in.
As the senior Devin Flaherty looks on at this senior versus freshman matchup. Strike two.
Back to the real home run that could not be robbed. Third inning blast sent out to left field. Freshman phenom. Probably win freshman of the year.
Tap back to May. Two down. Sooners one out away from the World Series. And standing in the way is Kaylee Harding. The ground out, a single, and a solo home run tonight.
Always seems to come down to a senior. It could be their last at bat, getting a chance to extend not only their own career, but their team season. And Harding has been one of the best in that Seminole uniform.
Need a base runner to get the tying run to the plate. May jumps in front.
Nice pitch. May has been more surgical these last couple weeks.
Harding, ground ball, Brito to first, ball game. And the Oklahoma Sooners win the Norman Super Regional. And their quest for the four-peat will continue in Oklahoma City.